I think the reality is that today the Senate will name conferees. As you know, the House named theirs a couple days ago. The president has encouraged both Speaker Ryan and Leader McConnell and their respective delegations to move as quickly as possible. We're anxious to get a bill on the president's desk before Christmas. I think there's just a couple small issues that need to be tightened up. One is particular to the pass-throughs. As you know, that was a debate on the Senate floor. Ron Johnson and Senator Steve Daines were very concerned about pass-throughs being equated equally with C-Corps. And to help increase the deductions for pass-throughs, there were changes made and brought back the AMT tax. I think a lot of us want to see the AMT tax gotten rid of. So I think that'll be one of the issues dealt with in conference. But we don't expect that it's going to be a contentious conference or a long conference. We expect this will be done very rapidly. And again, we hope to have a bill on the president's desk before Christmas.
Do you go to does it stay? It's, does it, are there seven or four in the final bill, do you think, in terms of brackets?
I think one of the president's priorities was to simplify the tax code. And so I think that we do have a preference of trying to get it down to a smaller number. I don't know that we'll get it down to four, Joe, but we do think that it's better to be a more simple tax code. That's one of our arguments all along.
On that point, though, the top tax rate is different in those two bills.
Right.
Are you looking at 39.6% being the top rate or 38.5%?
I think the president is more comfortable with a little bit lower, Becky, because I think, as you know, and you guys have covered on your network, one of the ways that we're paying for the significant corporate relief and middle income tax family relief is that we're eliminating the deduction for state and local taxes. And so those that are the beneficiaries of those deductions typically are at the higher income levels. And so therefore, to offset that, removing that deduction, we'd like to lower the top rate just a little bit.
Yeah. It's interesting you would say that, because I have a friend, because we live in this area, New York and New Jersey, and I've got some friends that do pretty well. They're kind of blown away when they actually do the numbers, Marc. And you know, when Reagan did things, when conservatives talk about tax cuts, they usually don't. You know, I remember President Obama always used to say, well, you know, these folks can afford to pay a little bit more. That's what's happening here. For these corporate rates to get to where they are, there's people on the high end, many of whom are basically subsidizing the lower corporate tax rates.
Well, Joe, we don't want to have tax increases on individuals.
Well, there are. They're large.
Joe,
I mean, they're
Joe, no, yeah. let's finish this.
Large
Joe,
tax one increases. Of our, this friend
no,
of mine.
No, I don't know about your friend's particulars, Joe, but the reality is that the president said all along he was going to focus on providing corporate tax relief because our tax system had become outdated. You've covered as well how many countries have actually reduced their corporate rate below 20%.
No,
that's why corporations are moving overseas. We need to bring those jobs back. He also said he wanted to focus on middle income tax relief.
Right.
And so, you know, you can't have it both ways. We can't have
Democrat
senators saying, hey, this is only a tax cut for the rich, and now saying, hey, wait, the rich are getting hurt.
Everybody complains about income inequality, and I understand. I honestly believe that lower corporate tax rates are what we need to make our corporations more competitive, tighten up the labor market. People can, you know, choose from three or four different jobs, some of which pay higher. And I mean, we've tried, you know, manually doing it in the last 8 years with, you know, the increase of minimum wage. We see how dividing up a small or the same size pie works. That's never going to work. It doesn't work. So we need the growth. So I understand that someone has to pay for it. Let me ask you this. The president, out of the blue, seemed to move off the 20% requirement. If you did do 22, your pass-through issue gets easier to deal with. The SALT issue gets easier to deal with in terms of whether you modify it a little. Everything becomes a little bit easier to do if you go to 22. Is that something that could finally be, you could do the AMT? And some things wouldn't be temporary like they are now. There's a lot you could do at 22. Makes a big difference. Is that possible?
Your math is right, Joe. We like 20%. We think the 20% is the right number.
Well, zero, but
I don't think that's practical. But I think that we do have the votes to get 20%, and that's what we're trying to do. And I think is we've covered. Other nations have actually gone below 20% and luring American companies away. So that is a priority for us.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.